朋友们大家好，欢迎您收看我的频道。前几天我在一期视频里发布了我先生为我在做历史的讲座，他每次为我讲课都要把那个小黑板搬过来，一边写一边讲。
It's one of these random...There are thousands of these that call themselves Christian. They are very, very similar to all of these.
How to call this?
Christian.
Oh, that's, yeah.
They just call themselves Christian.
Oh, Christian.
But what they really are is a form of Protestant.
Oh, Protestants.
朋友们看了以后都问我啊，他们说你的先生很会讲课。我说是的，我先生就是一个书呆子，他就喜欢给人讲课。所以每次他讲完以后，他都会对我说，这是一堂营养课，这是一堂生物课，这是一堂化学课。他就是这样一个人，他没有其他别的爱好，他就是喜欢看书，喜欢思索一些离奇古怪的事情。不过他的知识面真的很宽，不论你问到什么，他都会给你长篇大论的讲一通，也不知道他是怎么记住那些事情的。所以我有什么问题，我就喜欢问问他，看看他是怎么说的。比如说最近美国社会上出现的这些针对华人的一些歧视的现象，他是这样说的。
You mean people from other races?
Oh, yes.
Well, I mean, it happens here for the same reason it happens everywhere else in the world. It's actually sort of bred into human beings to think of everybody in terms of whether they're part of my group or not part of my group. It doesn't matter whether you're talking about people who are from different races because of the way they look, or different religions, or different political parties.Everybody thinks of everybody else in the world as part of in my group or not in my group. And when it comes to physical characteristics that identify people being from one part of the world or another, it's very easy to identify them as part of my group or not part of my group at 50 yards, even before they start speaking. So the easier it is to identify someone as outside my group, the more likely someone is to discriminate against them.
Thank you.
虽然他是一个白人，但是他对美国社会的这种种族歧视是非常仇视的。他对弱势群体总是充满了同情和关爱。在和他的交谈当中，我真的能够感觉到他灵魂深处的那种善良和美德。所以我们非常喜欢探讨各类问题，尤其是在这种交流的过程中呢，我也能够学到很多东西，也学会了以不同的视角去看待美国的社会。我觉得这一点对于我们生活在美国的华人来说非常的重要。我们总是喜欢拿过去的那种思维模式去考虑问题，我们就不能很好的理解美国社会发生的各种各样的现象。我先生经常告诉我，来到美国不仅仅是要掌握语言，更重要的是学会以美国人的思维去考虑问题。
It's only for
or faint?
Faint.
Faint.